So speaking about harmony, let's hope into harmony then. Listening to harmony serves at least three things. First, it lets you get a more profound meaning of the music. Lets you see all the details of emotions throughout the piece. I think that's clear. So even if you come to the piano and you just play all the chords with the pedal and you listen to them and you try to understand what is it about, you will have the whole movie in front of you, the whole life of this piece. Second, it affects your touch, because when you imagine sound texture, timbre, whatever you want, with the color, all the scent of every harmony, it will bring lots of different sensations to your fingertips. You know what I mean. So this, what I just show you in information, when you imagine it also in your mind, this note in a grieving E minor would give a certain impulse to your second finger, okay? Now this note in a more painful and open harmony, more intense harmony, would be imagined differently and would give different impulse to your second fingertips. Of course you can say I'm just playing louder, but that's not only about it. And third, it affects your intonation, your internal singing, because imagined in harmony sounds changes our singing, changes the color of intonation. That's precisely what I just showed you a minute ago. If I would imagine this and this in the color of this note, and if I sing, you can hear the difference in my sound. Wait. Okay, so. Now look what is happening next. If I'm going to the upper note from this color, sound this way. If from here, it's from here. So you see, in the distance between here, I'm singing differently. So it will affect the way you played. So let's just go through some harmonies. Just give you some ideas what I felt in this harmony. So what I think is this piece consists of three basic harmonies. First is just a simple grief harmony. Sorrow, very E minor, in other words. Music can explain better. Second is more tense and dark, like these ones. And the third, more intense and open, like from here. More open, some of them more intense, and some of less of them less intense and more open. So these are three basic harmonies. Okay, let me just show you some parts. So for example, here when you go, when you play here, So this one for me sounds more open. And this sounds more closed and dark. So in this case, it creates the effect of a sigh or a question, you know? Like when, you know, or why, you know, or help me. Or later on, you will see when he goes to the climax part, he finally breaks through this frozenness of grief and he gets a little bit of fire and he gives this clear, intense harmonies, diminished. But then again, you see Chopin comes back. It's not like Beethoven who would just keep going like errors with the same diminished harmony for like the whole page. In the same bar, he comes back to again more soft and beautiful. And then the next bar is just a despair, the chord full of desperation. Like he wants to, he finally managed to kind of get through this grief and, you know. And again, the same bar, he goes again to softness. Same question, more open and more strict. And I've got the end. And then he comes here. You can clearly hear a question here. Nothing in the silence back to him. And so he decides to die. This is like a quiet despair in the final chords.